that was a campaign, aka not a good one.
Yeah,
it was a failed campaign. That was something else. Lynn Vander Designer Diary number the sixth, I think. Fifth? Sixth? I don't know.
Six.
Six. Is it six? Six. Number six. This is number six. And hoo-wee! That's a failed game. Terminator, Genesis, Rise of the Resistance, gone. The campaign is over and we did not succeed. In fact, we didn't just like really not succeed, we really did not succeed. But that's okay. I mean, all things considered, it was still pretty good. Sadly, higher than any campaign we've ever launched before when we used to be publishers, even at a failed rate. Publisher's doing pretty good, I think. The game's getting made no matter what. I guess the Kickstarter was just to sort of help out. We went up against the Titans, we lost. There were campaigns out there like Zombicide and Street Fighter and Fireball Island, Hellboy, and a bunch of other names that I don't know, but they were all in the millions, so they're kicking ass. Right? I don't even know who they are, and they're doing really well. That's good. So, anyway. But thank you out there if you're one of the 400 some odd backers that's decided to hold on to the end. And you know what's really crazy? I was doing the math. It's like literally double the amount of backers if the people who canceled had stayed in, we'd have been well past the funding goal. So the retention rate was really off this time around. And what that means for future Kickstarting campaigns, I don't know. But it just shows you that IP doesn't really matter. Or does it? So, anyway. Want to see something cool? Well, first off, you might have noticed that I cut my hair. What do you think? Yeah? Shorter hair, longer hair? A lot of people that are just kind of getting to know me are thinking, they were making comments of, oh my God, you cut your hair, you look so different, blah, blah. And then, as Aaron was saying over here, that it's pretty much just standard me. You'll see older Kickstarter videos where my hair was short like this. I just, I grew my hair out long for a film role that never got shot, and it's taken a long time for that and the board game to be completed. Because we're doing a board game that's part of a film. But both of those are taking a little longer than we anticipated, and I feel by the time we get to camera, I'll have my hair growing out again. Hey, there's an Aaron in the background. Say hi, Aaron.
Hello.
He's just in the background doing his thing.
I'm just measuring stuff. Sometimes I measure things.
Josh is updating the Kickstarter currently. So I also did something really crazy. Check it. You can't see it? Yes, you can. I have to stand up. Kabam. What do you think of that? Tattoos. Yes, folks, they are real. They are in their healing stages, so they're a little bit crusty right now. The skin is flaking off. They're about 6-7 days old. Brand new spanking tattoos. Let's talk a bit about them, shall we? So here's the thing. This is the Dark Knight. Everyone knows I'm obsessed with Final Fantasy. So this is the Dark Knight. This is on my off arm. My off arm is the embodiment of where I came from, which is the darkness. I had a pretty good childhood in terms of like what my grandparents did, but my home life was really rough, kind of stupid, and lots of drugs involved and stuff like that. And so this is where I come from. Which is where the dark decisions come from. But it's on my offhand because it's not my strength. But I do need to dip back and forth into the dark side from time to time to sort of figure it out. But if you're Final Fantasy II fans, this is Cecil the Dark Knight's rendition, my rendition of Cecil the Dark Knight. The tattoo, and both tattoos were done by our artist, our Legacy of Mana artist, Stephen Belshaw from the UK. Go Stephen, rock on. And thank you, my friend, for designing these for me. They are wonderful and now a part of my life for the rest of my life. So the Dark Knight represents the other side. So then we've got this paladin kicking in here. This pretty cool sugarloaf helm, which Aaron is totally jelly of. And this is the paladin. So it's the blue and the yellows and the orange and the white flame, the holy flame. This represents, is also my dominant arm. So this represents the where I'm going, the good decisions that I have to make, the tough decisions about being a good person and doing what I can to help others. Do the best I can to better myself and to better others that are around me. So, the Dark Knight and the Paladin. And those are my tats. a new tattoo. Do you have tattoos? If you've got tattoos,
like, comment, subscribe.
Yeah, like, comment, and subscribe.
If you don't have tattoos, you know, comment, subscribe.
I don't like that stuff. I'd like to say subscribe and all stuff, but I hate that like, comment, subscribe stuff.
I just love doing it ironically.
I watched a YouTuber the other day, yesterday. I think his name is Webhead.
Okay.
Is it Webhead? You heard
I've
that one?
Never heard of him.
Anyways, I want you guys to watch the video and count how many times he says definitely. Definitely subscribe, you know, you guys definitely like the video, definitely like this, and definitely like that. I'm like, holy shit, guys, stop saying the word definitely.
Anyway. The like, comment, subscribe stuff is the most pandering thing you can do in a YouTube video.
Like, comment, subscribe.
That's why I like to do it ironically, like, make a stupid joke out of it.
Yeah, make a stupid joke out of it. Like, you don't have to subscribe if you want. In fact, you can even thumbs down the video. I don't even give a shit.
If you like tattoos, uncomment, don't like, and don't subscribe.
Don't like, don't subscribe, keep watching the video.
And if you don't like tattoos, don't comment.
And if you don't like, subscribe, don't like. Yeah. So anyways, these are my tats. They're so badass. They're still kind of, it feels like a sunburn that's finally gone away. It's just itchy skin part, but I can't scratch it still because it's like, the skin's pretty much off it now, but it's like, whew, badass. That's right, I'm badass, got a tattoo now, you know. I got something cool, a friend of mine gave me something. Check this out, it's a Zelda sword. It's a Zelda letter opener. Which is totally cool. It's actually going to Afterlife, the video game bar that we own. And that's a cool thing. Yep. Okay, so let's talk about games. People who were watching, who were part of the Terminator video, the last part of the Terminator video, the last part of the campaign, watching the live stream, we said that we had some cool licenses that we were able to tell you about, finally, because the publisher gave us the A-OK to tell you about these licenses. So, the publisher's name is Dynamite. I love Dynamite. You guys like Dynamite? You guys fans of Dynamite? Great. Dynamite Entertainment? Hold on, I get something to drink.
You know what I can say about Dynamite with confidence?
I got three drinks. What's
Dynamite
that?
Is Dynamite.
Dynamite is Dynamite. Okay, I got water. I got water. I got tea. Almond rooibos tea. Because of the caffeine levels, right? And then I contradict myself by also having an espresso. That's right, I'm rocking three beverages. Why? Because I own a cafe and I can. I also have behind me in this box right here 500 Ferrero Rochers. On a limited supply of Ferrero. You guys want Ferrero? Okay. More Ferreros, guys?
Always.
Ferrero for Aaron. Ferrero, Josh?
I want to point out I only caught that because the video's on.
Yeah.
Normally it would have been on before like Josh's.
Oh, that's true. Well, the video didn't catch it. Ferrero Rochers. Brought to you by the famous Jesse Drenters. Thank you, Jesse. The chocolatier. I get so many of these a day. Hundreds of the stupid things. That box is full of Ferrero Rochers. Oh, with espresso. Okay. Everyone's like fast forwarding. Yeah. Get to the licenses!
There's well, like top comment, licenses are 3 minutes, 45 seconds.
Yeah, yeah. Or just like, they you can save the link when it's like, whatever. Okay. Here are the licenses. The week of May 14th, on Kickstarter, through Dynamite, we are launching Tarzan, which is a cool license. Not as cool as what I'm going to tell you that we're launching the month after. But Tarzan, we're doing a cool Tarzan based on the comics, and it's a pretty cool game so far. We've had an outside designer help us on this one. So if you're watching Mac, kudos to you, my friend. You created a very cool game concept to work with, and we love the development that you're working on it. So jump, you know, shout out to Mac. Guys, I'm doing a vlog here. Do you mind?
Oh, sorry, we'll just stop working.
No, you guys can keep working. And then, so that's the week of May 14th. So it's basically 2 weeks from now we're launching Tarzan. So save up your pennies. I don't know how Tarzan's gonna do in terms of like success with the insane million-dollar campaigns that are out there right now. But at least Street Fighter and Zombicide and all these other campaigns are going to be over with by then and gone. Pledge managers are still going to suck up money, but you know what? They'll be gone. Tarzan's a small game. It's got a small goal. We're not expecting it to be hundreds of thousands of dollars. It'd be nice if we can just hit the goal for Dynamite's sake. But the game after that, I think you guys are going to be feeling it pretty good. Or you're going to be feeling pretty groovy. Groovy. So yes, we are doing the official Army of Darkness board game. Those are fireworks, by the way, if you haven't figured it out. Yeah, that's a whole lot of cheering from this section over here. Just people staring at their computer screens doing work. The enthusiasm's all gone.
Well, now the viewers can cheer.
Really? Are you cheering? Yeah, are you a fan of Army of Darkness? Are you a fan of Ash? Are you a fan of Deadites? Are you
a fan of Deadites?
I'm a fan of King Arthur.
I'm all about that King Arthur. He was a bit skeevy.
Yeah, that big King Arthur was a bit of a jabron. But, yes, so we are doing Army of Darkness, the board game. The board game. And it's awesome, eh, so far? Holy cow, guys. Look who's on screen for the first vlog ever.
Working hard.
The myth has been realized. Josh exists. He's part of the team. You see it firsthand. I don't have the patience for the visual effects to have put him in to be a fake thing. So, Army of Darkness, what's that going to be like? Well, it's going to be fun. we'll have to tell you more about it when we're allowed to talk more about it. We're just letting you know that it will have miniatures. So far, the sculptors are Dargon Jargon. These are my fireworks. And Dargon Jargon is going to be part of the delivery of the game with us with the miniatures. It's going to be just total badassery. Ash is going to have all of his goodies. We're going to have, Evil Sheila in there. We're going to have the Necronomicon. We're going to have all kinds of fun. But we are, in fact, doing Army of Darkness for Dynamite Entertainment, along with Tarzan. Two games, 2 months, two back-to-back Kickstarters. Reanimator will be in your hands very shortly. I believe it's delivering within a week or so, and then it starts getting put into backers' hands. So Dynamite is just kicking some butt. They're so good. They're just like, launch, 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 launch. Somehow between now and then, there's also going to be another board game that we have designed the cooperative version for, and it's for Shadowrun Sprawl Ops. That's still coming. It's still down the pipeline. We are just in the approval stage. The Kickstarter is 90% built. I don't know when that's launching, but if we know anything about our luck, it will launch probably the same time or around the same time as Tarzan or Army of Darkness, therefore making us have to do two Kickstarters at once.
We can handle it.
Yeah, we can do it.
We're professional.
We're fine. We're good. We're good. Yeah, I don't need to sleep anyway. Who needs sleep? So, cool. That's that. Do you guys have any questions? I'll start with you. That's a great question. Army of Darkness, when will it be released after it's Kickstarted? Well, the good news is that Army of Darkness is, we're going to attempt to make it a Q4 game. But most likely it'll be a Q1 2019, because when you're dealing with miniatures, you have a lot to deal with. Lots of crap to deal with. We've learned that the hard way with the Legacy series and all the stuff that we've yet to do. So that's that. I'm excited. There's a lot of cool stuff coming up. I got a link down below. That link leads you to lynnvanner.com, which then shows you a bunch of programming that we're doing at Gen Con. We are going to be at Gen Con in August. That link will give you all the information. Sign up for the stuff now. We're doing Legacy of Mana 5th Edition, Legacy of Mana Pathfinder. We're doing Buffy, Friends and Frenemies. We're doing Dragon Ball Z. We're doing Cowboy Bebop, Reanimator. Fucking hey, hip hop, hooray. We're doing like everything. All the Legacy games, including Miyamoto's Legacy, which is the newest of the Legacy family. And after Street Fighters has some time to calm down and everything's working out, Jasko and Lynn Vander will be kicking Miyamoto's Legacy sometime in the next couple of months, I think. So the new Legacy series, but we will not be kicking Miyamoto's until the Legacy Alliance product has been delivered to the backers' hands, which, as we know, could happen in the next 35 to 65 days. So we're pretty happy. That's a big range. But, I mean, D5 has been sitting in a harbor in Shanghai for God knows how long. Finally, I believe, paid for. I don't know, but, you know. So. Espresso gets bitter after it gets cold for a while. So the rolling you're hearing, which sounds like planes taking off, is actually just Aaron and Josh rolling back and forth to each other's desks, sharing notes about what they're working on. Josh is working on, it looks like he's working on some pitch concepts for another license that we've got, which you can't talk about yet. I know. We have so many things in the queue, but this license is, oh my God, it's just, it's like blood-suckingly awesome. It's so good. So Josh is working on the sell sheets for that, so the client can get the approval of the concept that we get to design. And hopefully we'll get that information given by our client that we can then tell you about and let you know when that's kickstarting, and or those products are releasing. But I'm telling you, you will love it because... And Aaron is working on... What are you working on?
Kickstarter fulfillment.
Kickstarter fulfillment.
Until the end of time.
Until the end of time. Kickstarter fulfillment. The endless Kickstarter fulfillment. That's for you, Legacy Line backers, if you're thinking about things. We're fulfilling Kickstarter stuff by collecting things. Printing things. I think that's it for now. I think we're gonna call that one a day. And we're gonna say that thanks for watching. And remember, keep it groovy. Keep an eye out for the games that are coming. Stay tuned for Terminator Genisys. It's not over yet, and we have so many more games down the pipeline. And if you're interested, let us know if you're going to Origins. Let us know if you're going to Gen Con. We are going to be there in full force. We got Lady Di, the head of the volunteer team, along with her killer partner, Missy. And the two of them are going to lead a killer volunteer team. We're going to do an awesome time down there. Definitely this, definitely that. Definitely check us out. Definitely like us. Definitely subscribe. Definitely, definitely, definitely. I hope Webhead attacks me because it's great. Thumbs down. Love everybody. Bye.